Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. In this video, we are going to make a Bushcrafted Native American style flute. And what we're going to use is right over here, out in this field, you see those white tops? That's the flower heads of cow parsnip. That's what we're going to use. So here's what we're looking for. Cow parsnip, or some, it's known to some people as Indian celery. This is in the family of some quite toxic plants, so be sure you know what you're picking. Okay, this is what the flower head looks like. All right, also another fact about this is I don't know what you call it, but it has a chemical on it that if you brush up against it, some people who are sensitive, have sensitive skin, they can be photosensitized to where they can blister. They can get blisters on them. So when you're gathering this and you're walking around in this, you might want to wear gloves just to be on the safe side. Okay, I don't have that problem, so I don't need to worry about it, but some people do. All right, now this is what the leaves look like right here. Kind of similar to a maple leaf, if you know what maple leaves look like. It's roughly similar. All right, what we're looking for, what we need, is last year's old dead dry stalks. So we're going to harvest this one. It's pretty good sized. We're going to harvest this and take it over to where we're going to work on it. Okay. There we go. All right, let's go work on it. All right, this is the tools we're going to use. I've got my walking stick here that I'll use as a cutting board. Okay, I've got my Gerber multi-tool, and on that multi-tool I have a very fine-toothed saw. It's like a hacksaw type teething on it. Okay, you don't really need that. You can get by with just a knife, but the saw is easier. A knife is a little bit harder. We're gonna cut this off. So, with a knife, we can roll back and forth until it cuts through. You don't want to force it, because if you force it, chances are you'll break fibers. You'll crack the whole project. So there, you can cut it off with a knife, but it's much easier if you have a fine-tooth saw. Now what we want to do is we want to check and make sure. See, on cow parsnip, it has joints in it, just like bamboo. And speaking of bamboo and joints, if you live in a place where you have bamboo, well, bamboo makes a traditional, it is a traditional wood used for making flutes, and much better suited than cow parsnip. The reason why I'm using cow parsnip is because we don't have bamboo in South Central Alaska, but we do have cow parsnip, and also river cane. If you have river cane in your area, that can also be used, and is used quite extensively to make flutes professionally. All right, now this joint here goes all the way through and seals off each chamber at each joint. So blow on it to make sure the integrity of that joint is good. Oftentimes you might find that it's got some holes through it. This one's good. Okay, now I'm going to cut off the other end, just square it up. All right, now what we want to do is, okay, if you notice, we're going to work the bottom of the stalk is this way. The top of the stalk is this way. This above the joint will be our mouthpiece. We're going to blow towards the bottom of the stalk where it gets bigger, okay? And we want to, if you notice here, the mouthpiece is straight, and then at the joint it bends up. I don't know if you can see that or not. It goes straight here and then bends up right here. Okay, we're going to use that. That's where we're going to place our holes for the flute. Because this, since this is higher than this, hopefully it'll help catch the air better, make better sound. And speaking of the quality of sound, this is not a quality flute. This will be suitable for one time use around the campfire, you know, bushcrafted on the spot, but this will not be concert quality. Okay, now I shaved off, there's a ridge around here at the joint, so I shaved that off. Actually, I want to just go ahead and shave it off around there for a distance. Shave that ridge off. Okay. Now, relocate where we want the sound, the holes. Okay, now from that joint, I'm going to go an eighth of an inch away from the extreme edge of the joint, and then I'm going to go about a quarter inch from that to make my first cut. And I'm going to make the cut at an angle, because this is going to be our what you call the sound hole. So I'm going to make it at an angle to help catch the air and deflect it in. Okay, this is going to be, you want to end up with a hole that is roughly roughly half of the diameter of your bore, interior bore, the bore hole. And work carefully with this stuff so you don't split it and damage it. Okay. I found it's easier to make both sideways cuts before we cut with the flute. It just seems to work better. Okay, there's our true sound hole, they call it. Okay, try as best you can not to damage any of the interior, because this cow parsnip has a rather fragile interior. Okay, now this is about a quarter of an inch from front to back, and a little bit longer than that side to side. Okay, now we need to make the hole on the other side of the joint for our air supply. And this is a hole into what is called the slow air chamber. Oops. Now see, I just made the mistake of cutting the line with the length before I cut both sideways lines. In this case, it turned out okay. All right. Now, what we need to do is we need to get an old piece of scrap piece of this to put over, slip over to, I believe that's called the fipple. No, I guess that'd be called the bird. Okay, I'm kind of flattening off the radius here between these so that when I put another piece on here over the top, there'll be an air hole created. If that makes sense. Okay, we need to cut this off flat. Try to use my saw for this. See how this works here. Okay, the moment of truth. Is it gonna make sound? First of all, I see some crud in here that needs to be cleaned up. The smoothness of the air hole needs to be cleaned up. You want that, especially that ramp going down in, you want that as clean as possible. Okay. Looks like it's going to work. Now what we need to do is, you know, this just happened to be the right diameter to slip over this pretty good. Okay, what we need to do is go get us something to tie this on with. You can use any diameter. I mean, you can use, you know, other pieces. Here's one. Maybe this will work as well. Need to be shorter. Okay, that cracked. I don't know if this will work or not. Okay, it actually works pretty good. But we'll go ahead and use this big one. I'll go get some grass and I'll be right back. Okay, I've got some grass here. But while I was gathering the grass, I also found a stem of a dandelion flower. It looks like it might work just as good or better. So we'll try that. Use whatever you got on hand. That's what bushcrafting is all about. Wrap it around several times. It's not gonna work. So we'll go ahead and use the grass. Okay, now we'll check it again just to make sure we still got air. All right, now, how to make the sound holes. Like I said, this is not going to be concert quality. This is going to be made more or less in the fashion that the Native Americans made it. They didn't have our pentatonic tuning scales with our electronic tuning instruments and whatnot, so we're going to make it the way they did. Now, I need to figure out halfway. So what I'm doing is centering this piece of dandelion stem on here, bending it in half to find the halfway point. Okay, it should be roughly about here. Okay, this says it should be about here. So, right in between the two should be halfway. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go a quarter inch down from this point. Actually, go about 3/8 of an inch down and make a mark. Now I'm going to go, this will be the center of our third hole. Now I'm going to go about an inch down, a little less than an inch maybe. That'll be the center of our second hole. And a little less than an inch, that'll be the center of our third hole, or our first hole, excuse me. Now let's make, go up, make another hole, about an inch or so above that one. And we'll make one more, right here. Now, what we're gonna do is just like we did to make these holes. Make them about a quarter inch by quarter inch. Now, if you're interested in tuning, I'm not going to bother with this one. But if you're interested in tuning, a smaller hole makes a see if I can remember. Makes a flatter note. The bigger the hole, the sharper the note. Meaning higher the frequency. Yes. Now these holes are probably too big. But we're just going to play this however it ends up. Let's see how it sounds so far. I'm gonna make this one a little bit bigger. See if we can change the pitch a little bit. That's a little better tune. All right, let's cut out our last two here and see what we've got. Okay, now typically the right hand goes on the bottom, the left hand goes on top, but that's really not necessary, however you're most comfortable. This may not be a concert quality flute, but neither am I a concert quality player. But you get the idea. And I hope you enjoyed the video. And we'll see you guys on the next video. Hey, you have a good day.